Hey, we gotta do it to them, but hey, it be like that sometimes, you know? Yeah, what's going on, peoples? This is your boy, Sony Legend, SLO1, checking in with y'all once again. Hey, we back in the Legend Lounge, just kicking it right now. We're gonna go ahead and tackle this tough issue, this tough topic, you know what I'm saying? My intent is not to be controversial, really, or to just provoke people, or most importantly, to get attention. That's not my intention. Basically, it's to provide unbiased view about a religion or set within a religion. You know what I'm saying? I don't see any real progress there. It's mainly tradition, and it's mainly folklore. And we're in a time that, you know, people need to pull the wool from over their eyes, you know what I'm saying? Because they swear they see the truth and know it, but they don't. They don't know the half. So anyway, cutting into the topic. The name of this topic tonight is Christians and Hebrew Israelites are getting played by the same pimp. I wonder if they know that. Once again, the name of the topic is Christians and Hebrew Israelites are getting played by the same pimp. And you're like, how can that be? How can that be? Well, most importantly, I guess with anything, you got to know your history. And I'm not talking about a set or a people's history. It's just history of human beings. And just understand what that word is and know there's a big difference between the truth and the history. Like what it states, it's historic. That doesn't necessarily mean it's the truth. And that's what people are going and running off of, history, instead of seeking the truth, and they think they have it. So ultimately, the Christians basically, you know, of course, worship Christ, and they put a go-between person between themselves and God. And that's a form of mind control, because within this universe, you know, everything is God. Every atom, every molecule, there's no separation. There's no time and space, the Alpha and Omega. It's an illusion to think that you are separate from anything, you know. And that's serious, you know. And they're playing upon your weaknesses and your ignorance, you know. The separation of church and state never left. The control has always been within Europe, within the Vatican, you know. But people don't see that, you know. Why is there a church? I live in the Bible Belt, you know, down south, ATL, you know. Every two blocks, you can see several churches. I mean, some of them are old and some of them are abandoned, and they're just there as landmarks. You know what I'm saying? When I see a church that nobody no longer goes to and it's just an abandoned building, to me, that's just telling me that mind control stopped working, that people saw the light. And these old traditions and values are becoming obsolete with this new information age. People are coming into this knowledge and applying the knowledge, but still the rate is too slow. Are you ride or die, ride or die? You know what I'm saying? Is it onward Christian soldier or onward Christian coward? Either way, that's an oxymoron, but you know, it's all good. But I know I'm kind of all over the place, but that's just kind of my style for this evening. But with the Hebrew Israelites, my main concern is, you know, how do they figure that they're separate from the ideology that the normal Christian has, no matter what the denomination is? You know, hey, y'all looking for Yahweh. Christians are looking for the return of Christ. Your definition of how this person, the physical characteristics may be different. But at the end of the day, it's some nigga falling out the sky. Somebody coming out the sky. Maybe a nigga. Maybe Caesar Bonger, you know. But yet and still, there's nothing supporting your statements. You know, it's just a story that's been told year after year, you know. When he's going to return, nobody knows. nobody knows when he will return, you know. And that's the game. That's the con. There will be no return. And I know that's going to hurt a lot of people's feelings that I say that. You know what I'm saying? But, I mean, you got to realize that from day one, you've been lied to. How do you think you guys was so easily caught up in the whole Obama hype? You know, change that you can believe in, hope. And y'all invested so much energy into this individual just to be let down. Just to be let down. And he was a puppet. You know, he's pushing forward the agenda at a faster rate than Bush is. You know, I'm like, don't be weak. Be who you are. Break your mind control. Be strong. Be free. Be a free spirit. You know, if it's Christ that you believe in and it's the discipline that you needed to get from point A to point B, so be it. You know what I'm saying? But hey, I have to be honest with you, Ten Commandments is not hard. Ten Commandments is not hard. You know? And how your pastor, I mean, aka your pimp, is pimping you. I'm like, hell, first Jesus was white, then he was black. And Jesus wanted you rich. I mean, go figure, son. You know, I mean, the hypocrisy is just, it's just insane. But anyway, you know, to each his own. But back to the churches, though. I mean, you got to understand. I remember I went to there's a city within, you know, Metro Atlanta called Marietta, historic Marietta. And it's just a big block, you know, like a, you know, old school town cities. You know, you had the little town square, the little park, the city hall, and, you know, the little shops and, you know, bars and things like that. But on each corners of this square town, the town square, was about four churches. So there was four churches on a square. There's just four points or four corners in a square. So that's four times four, which is eight. You got basically 16 churches within a 5-mile radius, less than 5 miles. That's what I'm talking about. That's mind control. And half those churches are just there for historic purposes. Nobody even go to them anymore. And, you know, some of them, but, you know, I mean, but just think about that for a second. Church and state never left. And the Hebrew Israelites, let me get back to them. They say, down with the Pope, down with the Vatican. But yet they're reading out the same playbook, the same product that the Roman Empire created when they conquered land to indoctrinate the people, to civilize the indigenous, you know, and say, hey, you know, don't worry, let us screw you over. You guys got Jesus. Jesus will save you. You got some Jesus juice, you know, bling bling, you know. I mean, boy, how y'all fall? How y'all fall off, man? Y'all, I don't know. It's not about logic. It's not about science. It's about making you feel good when you go to church. And I know that. Just make me feel good. Just like, you know, Halle Berry and Monsters Ball. Exactly. Why do you think they call it Monsters Ball? You know, Billy Bob Thornton had a ball, didn't he? Because all Halle Berry wanted to do was feel good. There you go. And that's where it all starts. So submit to your pimp. And be sure when you go to church, you know, pay your pimp. Give him that tithe money, you know what I'm saying? And grow your church rich. Or, my bad, I mean, grow your pastor rich. I mean, hey, it's ridiculous, son. And I know a lot of people are mad. They're upset with so many things that's going on in this world. So many things. But they got to think for a second. What was you doing? Was you just going with the okey-doke? Did you question anything? Was you caught up in your own individual world, lifestyle, etc.? Worried about trivial matters, trivial issues that's not going to even matter later on down the road? These are all valid questions that you have to ask yourself and do some serious self-analysis. And, you know, I know, hey, you know, maybe the way of life for your family may have been Christian. Hell, it was mine. I broke those chains still and asked very valid questions. And I got them back to the drawing board. But you know, if you're gonna stay on the Bible your whole life, then hey, that's all you. You know what I'm saying? I mean, that's just an algebra book. You know, there's so much knowledge out there. I don't care if you know the Bible in and out. You know, that's you. That's your cup of tea. If that's where you get your rocks off, so be it. Just know that you learn something that was supposed to be a stepping stone for something bigger. But you stayed there. You stayed on that level your whole life. It been played your whole life. And now everything is coming ahead. And what's down is up and what's up is down. You know what I'm saying? But when are you going to get it, clown? That's the question, I mean. But hey, you know, it is what it is, B. You know, I'm about to go ahead and sign out. You know what I'm saying? It's been a pleasure, been an honor to go ahead and touch base. I'd like to thank you guys for coming out to the Legend Lounge. Y'all be good. Y'all take it easy. And I'll be in touch. SLO.